Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how to represent a voltage and current into a phasor form and using phasor forms how to get resultant. So this is a problem. It says find the resultant of the following. That means there are four quantities given, all of them are voltages. E1 is given as 25 sin omega t, E2 10 sin omega t plus pi by 6, E3 30 cos omega t, and E4 20 sin omega t minus pi by 4. We are supposed to find out the resultant and we have to draw all phasors. So how to start? One thing you have to keep in mind, all these are the equations of a standard sinusoidal waveform. So first step, we have to compare these equations with standard sinusoidal waveform. So I am comparing with E equal to Em sin omega t plus phi. Make sure that all the waveforms or equations given should have this form, sin omega t plus phi. So if I compare first equation, I will get Em1 25 and phi1 is 0 degree. So I can say E1 can be represented as 25 at an angle 0 volt. So what I have done, from the equation I got a phasor form. Similarly E2 I can write directly, it is 10 at an angle pi by 6 radian. Let's convert that into a degree. So E2 is nothing but 10 at an angle 30 degree. I cannot compare E3 directly with this standard equation. Why? Because in standard equation it is sine and here it is cos. So I need to convert this cos into sine. So the formula is cos theta can be written sin 90 minus theta or sin 90 plus theta. Which one we will take? How to decide? Whenever I use a formula for cos to sin conversion, I have to make sure that theta should remain positive. Why? Because theta means omega t over here. And this is a frequency. So in a standard equation, omega t is always remains positive. So whenever I am to convert cosine into sine, I have to make sure that this omega t term should remain positive. Hence, I will use second formula. So the E3 is given as 30 cos omega t, which is nothing but 30 sin omega t plus pi by 2. So that I will get E3 as 30 at an angle pi by 2 radian, or E3 is 30 at an angle 90 degree volt. And E4 is given as 20 sin omega t minus pi by 4. Simple comparison will give me E4 as 20 at an angle minus pi by 4 radian, or in degree it will be 20 at an angle minus 45 degree volt. Now, considering all these equations, if I want to get a resultant, it will be very difficult problem, because every time I have to use sine to cos conversion or maybe a factorization, defactorization formula. Instead, what I have done, all the waveforms equations I converted into phasors, and these phasors I am going to insert in calculator to get a resultant. So, resultant EMF ER is E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar plus E4 bar. Bar indicates it's a vector quantity having a magnitude along with the angle. So, let's write what is E1. So, E1 we have calculated as 25 at an angle 0, E2 10 at an angle 30, E3 30 at an angle 90, and E4 20 at an angle minus 45 degree. If I insert this value in calculator and calculate, I will get resultant as 47.8024 plus J 20.8579 volt. It's a complex quantity, real part and imaginary part. But what we want this in a polar form. So, in polar form, I will get ER as 52.1548 at an angle 23.57 degree volt. Once you got an answer in phasor form, it will be very easy to write in a equation form. How? I can say ER is nothing but, this is the maximum value, because everywhere we have considered maximum value for E1, E2, E3 and E4. So, I can write over here ER equal to 52.1548 sin omega t, and angle I am getting over here is positive, so it is a plus 23.57 degree volt. Let's represent all the quantities in phasor diagram. So, let's represent the first quantity. E1 is given as 25 at an angle 0. So, the phase angle is 0 and having a magnitude 25. So, it will be like this. It's 0. So, along positive x axis. E2 is 10 at an angle 30. Let's represent E3. E3 is 30 at an angle 90. So, in anticlockwise direction, it will make an angle 90 with positive x axis. So, it will be like this. This angle is 90 degree. E4, 20 at an angle minus 45. So, minus means in a clockwise direction, making an angle 45. And what resultant we got? 52.1548 at an angle 23.57. So, it will be like this. And the angle made by this ER with a positive x axis is 23.57. So, this is how we can represent any sinusoidal quantity as a phasor, and using a phasor we can get a resultant phasor out of it. Thank you.